I think something I've always struggled with is actually getting turned on during sex.
There's always like a weird sense of unfulfillment and a little bit of emptiness, for sure. I remember one of my first ever Tinder hookups, I shaved my pubes for the first time. And I think the fact that I felt like I had to be a hairless baby down there is super toxic, but anyway. I met him at his place and it was very clear that the vibe was Netflix and chill. We made random small talk and then he was like, "Oh, hey, how about if we watch Afterlife?" And I was like, okay, sure. And then he was like, "Do you want to get under the covers?" And then he did something which I still find appalling and icky to this day, which is getting into bed fully clothed. Like most Asian cultures, I was raised to take off my shoes when I got home, to get changed into my home clothes so that you may sit on top of your bed, and only when you've put on your pajamas may you get in your bed. Anyhow, when the show ended, we talked for a bit and then we started making out. His fingers were pointy and fumbly, and I didn't know how to communicate that I wasn't into the particular party he brought into my pants. I was also worried about my newly shaved skin because we were getting sweaty and I was like, oh no, bacteria and ingrown hairs. When I walked home afterwards, I remember thinking, why was none of that hot? And did I really just watch a whole season of Ricky Gervais trying to rebrand into dramedy? I'm Namona, I'm 22 years old and I am an actor. I was born in Mongolia, in Ulaanbaatar. Some things that turn me on, nice hands that kind of look like they do work. Things that turn me off, hunting pictures, absolutely not. Don't have any time for that, no thank you. The whole thing felt very inorganic because one moment we were watching Afterlife with Ricky Gervais and then the next moment is like, let's get it on. I'm Marvin Gaye. I was just going along with it. Like, I wanted to have sex, but the way that it was unfolding, it didn't quite sit right. I didn't have the tools to navigate that or communicate what I wanted. I just always really wanted to know what amazing, mind-blowing sex was like, because that's kind of how it's portrayed in like media, and it's always this big, intense thing, and I just wanted to know what that felt like. I became more interested in trying to figure out what worked for me. So these are my sex toys. It's quite quiet. It gets louder. Louder. The first one I bought was like this massive, like, purple veiny dildo that vibrated, and it was, and looking back, it was like so ambitious of me to get that. But they gave me this little like complimentary bullet vibrator as well, and I remember trying out the dildo and I was like, why is this not working? Like, it doesn't feel that good. And then I tried out the vibrator and I was like, whoa, this is fun. I think penetration doesn't do it for me. Yeah, I think it's more about the clit.
A power balls.
Which is frustrating because, well, when I was growing up anyway, the stuff that I saw was just penetrative sex, and you don't really see a lot of the other stuff. Through my extensive research, I decided to try something called tantric masturbation. Part of it is creating a really nice and comfortable and safe space for yourself. Whether that be like, I don't know, candles and music and lighting and blankets. And lube. Lube is really important. And then you start with anything except like your boobs and nipples and your vulva and your clit. And you just take it like super slow, like slower than slow. Eventually you get to the clit. And then you play with that a little bit. And then maybe you might have an orgasm. And from when I did it, it was pretty great.
I learned that I can get really turned on and it just takes time. It felt powerful. I don't know, it made me feel quite capable. Yeah. Recently, I had this experience with a guy that went a little differently to the past hookups. We went up to his room. What is it with guys' rooms and having absolutely no character apart from a giant TV taking up half of the room? They need to step the hell up. Also, I was definitely not vibing the mattress straight on the ground. I think he was hoping for Netflix and not chill vibes, but I left a bit after 10 and politely declined his offer to stay. I feel a bit proud of myself actually for not pressuring myself to do more, because the person I was a year ago probably would have walked out of there with that weirdly empty feeling after a hookup. I think from my experience, heterosexual sex definitely focuses on the man's pleasure. But I feel more aware of it, and I think I feel I have a right to it, you know? Whereas before, I expected it to feel good, but I didn't know that I had a right to expect that. Having that knowledge about yourself definitely can affect the way that you carry yourself in your day-to-day.
I'm quite interested in this idea of dark sexual feminine energy.
It's the energy that comes from down here. And it's a life force, is what it is. Women are often perceived as objects for pleasure rather than as a partner in pleasure. There's two people involved in this interaction, and both of them have equal right to have pleasure. I'm going to take a stand for it.